What's up guys, Shawnee Dogs here, and in my video from about 2 weeks ago, when Cranked was still in the game, I told you that the fastest way to earn XP, keys, and salvage was through playing Cranked because of that greatly increased movement speed. It really sped up the game. Your games would finish in about 4 to 5 minutes at the most. Because of this, you were gaining XP, keys, and salvage at a ridiculously fast rate, faster than any other game mode. Now they have introduced Hyper Team Deathmatch back into the game, and if you don't know, what this does is it's basically just regular team deathmatch, but your payload meter recharges 7 times faster. So because of this, whenever they add these game modes in where something about the aspect of the game is just faster, you always want to play that. Now this one, you do have to use a pretty specific class setup to take advantage of this, get that XP as fast as possible. I will put the exact class setup down in the description below, but the main things that you want to be using, you want to use the Warfighter combat rig. The reason for this is combat focus. That is the ability that allows you to double your score for a short duration, and the reason that's so good in this game mode, your payload recharges 7 times faster. So you gotta think about it, even in just regular game modes, this thing comes back in around 1 to 1.5 minutes. So once you throw on that 7 times multiplier, by the time you get to mid map and you engage in a gunfight, the bar's already halfway full. It's completely ridiculous. And the other thing you wanna use to take advantage of this is the overclock perk in slot 1, because that also further increases your payload recharge rate. With the combination of these two things, the combat focus and the overclock, when you're playing Hyper Team Deathmatch, you will be earning XP at the fastest rate possible. And the other thing that really helps about using this method is it's really good for leaderboard spots. If you're pretty high up there on the leaderboards, there's no way to get score better than this. I was getting pretty much 8K score every single game. That is almost unfathomable. Just to put things into perspective, in the one team deathmatch game that I had a very long time ago, the world's most kills in a solo core TDM, I dropped 84 kills in that. Now with those 84 kills, I only had 6,700 score. So you're getting a hell of a lot more score than what is even humanly possible in regular team deathmatch because of all the combat focus you will be able to use. Now I will say, it will vary greatly from player to player. It really does depend on your skill. If you can manage to pick up 2 or 3 kills every time you use that combat focus, you're gonna get a lot more score than someone who uses it and maybe gets 1 kill like half the time. So while this does benefit really good players a lot more than it will benefit your average player, it still does benefit everyone. It's just not as much than if you were getting crazy amounts of kills every time you activated it, but it is still by far the fastest way to both level up, get those leaderboard spots, and there's really no negative to it besides the fact that because it's so fast paced, you might take on a few more deaths than if you were playing a regular team deathmatch, because you're going to be getting killed by a lot of payloads probably a lot more often. One thing that I forgot to mention earlier, you really gotta pay attention to your score streaks. You don't wanna be using a lot of assault score streaks because those eat into your max score. You wanna use complete support, the UAV, counter UAV, and advanced UAV to maximize your score. This was the way that I was able to do so well. Even in games where I didn't really get too many kills, I wasn't doing as well as I would've liked. My score never, ever dropped below 6K. Even in my worst games playing this. Support streaks are the way to go if you're trying to whore out points, and once you're using this crazy combo with the combat focus, hyper team deathmatch, times 7 bonus, overclock, and these support score streaks, you will see the massive amount of points going into your score. You'll end a game in around 4 to 5 minutes. It's about the same as Cranked in terms of length, and you're gonna get over 10K XP a game. Of course, depending on performance, that's what I was getting. Maybe your numbers might be a little bit lower, but on average, the amount of XP that you get in this is just absolutely ridiculous. You're gonna see here in a second, once it gets back to the lobby screen, exactly what I got. I don't know what's up with the keys. It was like glitched. It usually does this for the new game modes. It just doesn't show how many keys you got. So right here, you can see it, 14,000 XP. And this game barely took over 4 minutes. I ended up with over 8k score in this game as well, and it wasn't even my best one. It was just my best in terms of how it looked, the actual gameplay, that's why I put it up. But the numbers are just astronomical. I'm gonna show you some of the scoreboards that I got here. This one's an 8240. I almost managed to break 9k in one of the games. I was just shy, but still, these numbers are just unattainable in other game modes, and with the speed that you get them at, that's what makes this such a good method in terms of getting XP, getting those leaderboard spots. And if you're wondering why I haven't mentioned anything about keys or salvage yet, it's because that's a little bit of a different story. First of all, the fastest way to get salvage is through your keys, because the more supply drops you open up, and you want to be opening up the rare supply drops. I did a video on that, comparing the commons to rares, what you get. The rares are definitely better. You get salvage from that at a much faster rate than what the mission teams actually get you. So the more rare supply drops that you get, the more salvage you get. Now, in order to get these, you need the fastest way to get keys. Now, as I'm sure you've heard by now, almost every game mode has about the same rate at which you get keys. A lot of it just depends on how much time you actually spend in game. Now, the thing about that is in zombies, you can earn keys at a much faster rate than anything you can do in multiplayer. And while I don't condone this at all, and I don't actually do it myself because it requires you to spend a lot of time not in multiplayer. So if you do play zombies, you know the ins and outs. You'll know that there are a lot of glitches out there that allow you to make it to high rounds, and they recently changed things up. It used to be that you could only get 29 keys from a game of zombies, whether you made it to round 30 or you made it to round 200, it didn't matter, it was capped off. Now I believe there is no cap, so the further you make it, the more keys you will get. And what I've heard is people have been going to around wave 90, just sitting in a glitch spot, and then they'll just kill themselves and collect the keys. Now, of course, you don't have to glitch this out. If you're good at zombies, you could just make it to a high round legit. That's also what some people do, but those people usually quit out around 35. So it just depends what kind of risk you want to take. But these are the fastest methods out there. Whenever they introduce these new game modes that just speed up some factor of the game, it's usually gonna grant you the most XP possible. So you'd want to play that game mode. And in terms of keys, it's gonna give you roughly the same keys no matter what game type you play, although there are some exceptions. I know when I played Cranked, it was giving me like a lot compared to the amount of time that I spent in game. I don't actually know the exact numbers for this game type yet, but I do know that Cranked, it was pretty high. So that one was also very good for getting keys, but roughly most of the game modes, they all give you keys at pretty much the same rate. So if you wanna get the most amount of keys possible, zombies is the route to take. That is the way that you can earn much faster than you can in multiplayer. And because of this, you will also be earning massive amounts of salvage. Now, the thing that's good about playing Hyper Team Deathmatch is not only does it net you this ridiculous amount of XP, but it also benefits you in leaderboard spots. So it's really good for all you grinders out there. And these are the best methods that I know of. So I really hope that you guys did enjoy this video. You found it helpful. If you did, please be sure to drop a like. I really appreciate it. Comment down below with any thoughts or questions you may have. And as always, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. This gameplay that I have up right now, this was another really good game that I had on Genesis. I think I got over 8k score in this one as well. And then after that, I actually added another gameplay on there. It's on Frontier, just to show you, I didn't really do too well. Now, doing well, that's obviously relative to the player. I went 40 and 11, but that's not really a good game for me, and I still got 6,800 score in that game, which is a lot higher than anything I've gotten in recent history in Team Deathmatch. So this is definitely the route to go down if you're looking to maximize your gameplay experience. And that is going to wrap it up for this one. If you're new to the channel, please be sure to subscribe for some more great content. And I will see you guys in the next one.
Peace. the escape pods.
Is active.